Raptors have now won 4 consecutive games, and of course I had to wear this because they played like champions today. They played hard from the first minute. Well, they weren't great in the first quarter, but overall they played such a hard-fought game right from the get-go. Two things I want to say right away. First off, the next game is against the Knicks. It's a 1 p.m. tip-off there on Saturday. I won't be able to do the video right after the game because I'll be working, unfortunately, but it will be uploaded about, I want to say, between 5 and 6 o'clock, so it won't be too late after the game, but I want to give you the heads up right away. And you know what we're going to hear, Raptor fans, right? The Raptors beat the Brooklyn Nets 114-103, and they've won 4 straight. But no, they didn't have Kevin Durant. They didn't have James Harden. You know what my response to that is going to be? I don't care. The Toronto Raptors win this one 114-103. They improved to 25-34 on the year. And as much as people are scoreboard watching right now, right? You see the Bulls and you see the Wizards. It looks like the Wizards have come back and beat the Golden State Warriors, unfortunately. But in the end, the Raptors can only control what they can control. You know, you went out there today and you beat the Brooklyn Nets. That's what matters. It helps that you got help from the Cleveland Cavaliers of all teams as they beat the Bulls 121-105. So the Raptors have now jumped the Bulls for sole possession of 11th with the Wizards' win. I think they're still a half a game ahead of us for the 10th seed. But really, the Raptors, just all they can do is control what they can control, and that is going out there and getting W's. And they've won 4 straight, and they played a hard-fought game today. Let's break this baby down. First quarter, okay? You didn't play very well. You see all the starters back out there, OG, Fred, Lowry, Pascal, and everyone's back. And inside my gut, I'm like, this team's been playing really well over the last 3 games. These all guys come back. Is it not going to be a good game? And it's going to be like, it's going to look really bad on them. But they went out there in the first quarter and were really shaky. 36-23. Were the Brooklyn Nets leading after one quarter of play. Obviously, they haven't played a while. I think they've only played like 20 games all year together. So it's a little bit of adjusting there in the first quarter. But man, once that second quarter turned on, the Raptors start boogieing. And with about 3 minutes left in the first half, the Raptors turn on the Jets. And they get going. They finish the quarter really, really strong. And they win the second quarter 33-22. They only allow 22 points there in that second quarter. And all you're down by is 2 at halftime. Now, what Raptor team are we going to see coming out in the third quarter? That's been kind of the question mark all year long. It's great if you play a great quarter or a great half. But what are you going to get in the second half or vice versa? Well, in that third quarter, the Raptors kept that exact same energy on both ends of the ball. They scored 36. They only allowed 23. And the Raptors are up by 11 going into the fourth quarter. And in that fourth, yeah, the Nets made a few runs. But every time they got it close, they got to, you know what, they got it to 5 or they got it to 7. The Raptors counterpunched, right? And they brought the lead back up to double digits. And that's what good teams do when they bend and they don't break. Raptors and Nets only scored 22 points in the fourth quarter. However, the Raptors do pick up the victory and improve to 25-34. All right? Now, there's so many guys that you can say had great games today. All right? We'll start right at the top as I got all my notes here. Kem Birch was a starting 5 today. Man, I said something, and I've been right in a lot of videos. I can't believe I've said that. I'm not a very, you know, I'm a very humble person, but I've said a lot of great things, a lot of things that have actually been true in sports, whether it's baseball, hockey, or basketball. But the one thing that I said a while back, and you guys got on me for it, and it was well deserved, was that the loss of Ibaka and Marc Gasol was not, you can't go from a 50-win team to like the way this team was playing. And you guys were kind of at me about it. And you guys are right. Because the addition of Kem Birch and Freddie Gillespie, is insane. We are not seeing Aaron Baines go out there and play every night for the Raptors. You're seeing these two guys who play hard every single possession. And you've won 4 straight games. So I credit you guys for saying that in the comments and proving me wrong. But Kem Birch had 8.7 boards and 3 dimes today, shot 3 of 5 from the field. And hey, that's all we're asking from our starting five, right? We're not asking him to drop Joel Embiid numbers. You have all these other guys who are going to be shooting the ball a ton. Just go out there and give you energy. Give you 8, 7, and 3. I'll take that any day from Kem Birch. And OG Anunoby, oh boy, he was good today. 25 points, 3 boards, 1 dime, 8 of 14 from the field, 4 of 9 from 3-point range, and he had 2 blocks in the game, including that absolutely filthy throwdown there in the third quarter, a nasty slam for OG, which kind of bolstered his team and really gave him that edge to kind of build the lead up to double digits. Fred VanVleet had 17 points, 3 boards, 5 dimes, 5 of 13 from the field, was 5 of 10 from 3. Him and Lowry were really shaky to start this game, but made some big-time buckets there in the third quarter and even some in the fourth. So big job for those guys. And Kyle Lowry, as I mentioned, 14 points, 7 boards, 5 dimes. Shot 4 of 12, was 3 of 9 from 3-point range. So the Raptors getting it done, right? They're getting all their guys in double figures. They're shooting the ball from deep very well. And that's going to be, you know, something we talk about moving forward. And Pascal Siakam. Everybody loves harping on this guy, going after him, letting him hear it. But today, he was amazing. He was the player of the game in this one. You could say possibly OG. But Pascal Siakam was fantastic. 27 points, 9 boards, 6 dimes. Shot 10 of 19 from the field, sprinkled in 2 of 5 from 3-point range, and gave you 2 steals as well. He was outstanding today. The reason why is he's not trying to force shots, right? When the shot's not there, he's moving the ball, hence the 6 dimes. And when he's getting the ball in the paint and he's getting some room, he's going up there and taking his bucket with confidence. And that's why he's shooting 10 and 19. He's doing an unbelievable game for Pascal today. And the man that I am falling in love with basketball-wise, Freddie Gillespie. I've been talking about literally in every single video as of late. And yeah, I think he had a second 10-day contract. You gotta give this guy a rest of the season deal. The guy's playing with so much energy. Look, does the stat line look great? 4 points, 5 boards, 1 dime, shot 1 of 4. No, it doesn't look pretty. But he had 1 steal and 5 blocks. Energy at its finest for Freddie Gillespie. He's going to go out there and give you effort on every single possession. And you absolutely love that from your bench center. Coming off the bench doing absolute work. So attaboy, Freddie Gillespie. And Gary Trent Jr., a lot of mixed feelings having him coming off the bench. But I understand it with guys like OG, Fred, Lowry, and whatnot. I think all Raptor fans are kind of seeing this, right? When Lowry kind of calls it quits, whether it's his career, whether it's with the Toronto Raptors, whatever the case may be, we kind of see Gary Trent sliding into that role, right? Because we're all talking about that, you know, everyone hates the two, you know, guards, the way Lowry and Fred are always playing together. Everyone hates that. Well, Gary Trent is kind of that Norman Powell replacement. And it was always hard finding time to play Norm because you had this lineup that we more or less saw today. For Gary Trent Jr., he came off the bench a ton. They're in Portland. There's clearly a plan in place for Gary Trent Jr. He had 5 points, 4 boards. They shot 2 of 9, was 1 of 5 from 3. He had 2 steals in the game, so he's always going to give you that active defense, as Norm always did. But I think there's a more of a future plan for Gary Trent Jr., especially the way that this team looks right now. But what a job by the Raptors. And then you get 5 points off the bench from fully signed contract Yuta Watanabe. Attaboy, well-deserved contract for Utah. Getting the big boy money, and well-deserved, man. The guy's played hard all year long. Fantastic job for Utah. And Malachi Flynn had 5 off the bench. One of them was a 3-point shot in the fourth quarter. Mr. Fourth Quarter. I think he's shooting over 40% from 3-point range in the fourth. Oh, yeah. Love to see it. And Chris Boucher, 4.7 boards on 2 of 5 shooting. But that's not the reason I'm bringing him up. He left the game today with a left knee sprain. And it didn't look good. I think it was Cabarrot. Kind of landed on his ankle, and it was an ankle sprain or something, but he was grabbing his knee, and that's the official ruling was that. So we're all just hoping and praying that Chris Boucher is all right, because it seems like when they put him at the 4, he seems to be so good, right? When he's at the five, he's getting bodied by all these bigger guys. It just doesn't make sense for him. When you put him at the four, it's a much better matchup for Boucher. And we've noticed that as of late, and it's really unfortunate to see him go down today with the injury. Hoping he's all right, and whatever it is, hopefully it's very mild, and he's back with us very soon, but healthy, of course. Now, you guys know the three things I always look for in a basketball game and kind of see how the Raptors did. Now, how was the rebounds? Well, they were -2 in the glass and -3 on the offensive glass. So not great. You lost that one. How'd you do defending Brooklyn's three-point shot? Well, they only shot 32% from three-point range. You won that one. I don't know what the average for three-point shooting is in the NBA and whatnot, but the Raptors shot 38%. So you can kind of call it an even. So we didn't technically win two of the three categories, but You did a great job. You shot the three pretty well, 38% from three-point range, especially how bad it was in the first half, more or less the first half. They came on near the end, so a really good job overall by the Raptors battling back. And the big thing we always talk about, the Toronto Raptors, they always love to get out and run. They're a team that likes to get stops and get out and boogie on the floor and get in transition. Well, in the fast break today, the Raptors won 20-6. In the fast break. That's where the Raptors are at their best, and they showed that there this evening against the Nets in Brooklyn. All right, guys? And the next game, as I mentioned, is in New York, taking on the Knicks on Saturday afternoon. It's a 1 o'clock tip-off there. Raptors looking to get their win streak to 5 and to beat another playoff team. Obviously, the Nets were shorthanded, blah, 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 but they're a damn playoff team, and I don't really care who the hell's on the court for them. But the New York Knicks are playing very inspired basketball as of late. They're winners of, I think, 7 straight going into today's play against Atlanta. Whether they win or lose that, they've been playing some really good basketball as of late. The Raptors have a few days off before that game against the Knicks. So they got to get ready. They got to be prepared because they have a really tough schedule coming up. And it all, well, starting today, really. You got to go out there with a purpose like they did today on the defensive end. The Raptors allowed 22 points in the second quarter, 23 in the third, and 22 in the fourth. You go into New York with that same mentality, you're going to win that basketball game. It's not going to be easy, all hands on deck, but one game at a time for the Toronto Raptors. They're 9 games under 500. They've won 4 straight. They're on the 11th seed in the Eastern Conference. They're half a game behind the Wizards for the 10th spot, unless Golden State has some miraculous comeback there in the fourth quarter, in like the last minute of this game, then we have sole possession at 10th, but I highly doubt that, so I'll play devil's advocate and say the Raptors have sole possession of 11th in the Eastern Conference. You are right there. You got to keep playing hard, keep winning games. You got to get on a roll, and they are as of late. You got to keep going. Keep the train chugging for the Toronto Raptors, right? So you know what, guys? That is going to do it for this one. If you enjoy the video and enjoy the game there this evening, smack that like button to appreciate that. Hit that subscribe button if you have not done so already. Comment down below your thoughts on the video, your thoughts on the game. What'd you like? What'd you not like from today's game? If I missed any crazy highlight today, let me know in the comments, because there was a lot. I mean, there were so many things today. I really wanted to touch on the OG slam because that was nasty. And I wanted to touch on the Gillespie 5 blocks. If there's anything I missed, guys, let me know in the comments below. Twitter's down below for myself. Follow, send me a DM, all that great stuff. The Instagram link is down below, so follow up there if you have not done so already. And I will talk to you guys, Jays edition, very shortly tonight as they are taking on the Boston Red Sox at Fenway Park in the finale of the mini 2-game set in Boston. They were up 4-1. I got an update saying somebody got a double, and I think it might have been a 2-run double, so I'm not too sure what's going to happen there. But we'll talk to you guys post-game there. As for the Leafs, their next game, Winnipeg, tomorrow night in Winnipeg. 7 o'clock puck drop, 8 o'clock. Either way, they're playing the Jets tomorrow night in Winnipeg. Looks like Foligno and Ben Hutton are available, so that's great news. And since Zach Bogosian went down with an injury yesterday, looks like Ben Hutton might draw in for the Leafs tomorrow, and so will Nick Foligno. It's gonna be a lot of fun watching these new Leafs go out there for the Buds tomorrow, because they need it. They need a win. All right. So thank you. And that's And as for the Raptors, they take on the Knicks there on Saturday afternoon in New York at MSG. 1 p.m. tip-off there in New York, all right? So thank you guys so much for listening and watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. We'll talk to you guys then.